So anyway, if you have any questions, you can go in there. Otherwise, I'll just like sort of start to tell you some of the stories about like how this happened and some interesting things about writing the book. Because this is also about writing. Oh yeah, the Holmes thing. Well, I could go right to that because it's so bloody good. So when I got there, so all these guys. I don't know if you know about the list of. Oh wait. Well, anyway, there's. And so that gives you some idea of the headliners, right? And so this guy's here. But look at this, like Leary, Hoffman, Ginsburg, Corso. I mean, it was just nuts. And Kesey, who was really the guy I was going to, he was my hero I was going for. But so there was a gazillion people. And oh, the rose. A pretty girl gave me that at the Grateful Dead last night. Mm-hmm. And so I thought it kind of, the Jerry thing is a little much. Because it isn't really about Jerry. I just thought that would be here representing and for Jack and Neil and Ken and Jerry and all the rest you want to hear. But anyway, okay, now back to the Holmes thing. I was going to read something from it because it was just, because I think most of you are probably writers on one level or another, and if not, simply love good writing, and Holmes just riffs some stuff that I thought I would share. It's just kind of a good piece, and it's about, it's like I say, it's the guy in Holmes's chair, 30 years later, you know? Same size room, windows, yada. So I might go off on a whole bunch of stuff he goes into, which incidentally is very interesting. Oh, and this ties into, the cassette deck. So on this trip of all insane things, I bring a couple of notebooks and a cassette deck so I can record stuff. And I recorded Holmes's talk, for instance. And so I was able to listen to it again 30 years later, as a writer. And back then, I was just in awe. I'm like, how do you do it? And he conveyed all this great stuff about writing. As he's casually but emphatically imparting all these learned laws of literature. Like, the hardest thing for a writer to do is to find their own voice. That you can't just wish it into being. You have to earn it by continually writing. And it may not come for many years and many books. It's like Miles Davis's line, you have to play for a long time before you can sound like yourself. And about how writers have to be able to look at themselves objectively, but then write subjectively. That only you have your unique view of the world. Perception is like snowflakes. And you have to practice accurately transcribing your visions and impressions into sentences. And that an effective trick for beating a temporary writer's block is to read something you've recently written and remind yourself you can do it. But that every author winces when reading something written many years earlier. Quote, I'll read a passage from years ago that I didn't know how to make work then, and now I can fix it in 10 seconds. And how writers read all the time. And how you've got to continue to self-educate. That if you're a committed writer, it's an ongoing, never-ending process until you die. And that reading books plus experience equals an education. And that the Beats form their own school without walls, with living rooms and bar booths as their classrooms. And anybody can add a new book to the syllabus. That you don't have to be accepted into a university or pay somebody tuition in order to follow a reading list and learn. And the importance of journal writing. How he's kept them his entire adult life. I certainly recommend it. And so did Jack. And how that, and how Jack did as well, and how you can be completely honest and straightforward there. You don't have to worry about sentence construction or paragraphs or linear your flow. It's just a sketch pad, a confessional, a best friend, a hard currency memory bank. A place where you can find your own truths. He said how Mark Twain was a great writer, but a bad novelist. how Yeats was born physically tone deaf, but was the most musical of all poets. How Hemingway read a lot of poetry to keep up his prose chops. How Jack and John considered Henry Miller a kindred spirit and a direct father of what they were doing. How they both loved D.H. Lawrence. How younger readers want action and a fast-moving plot, but as you get older, you see how Henry James is just as exciting as any shoot-'em-up novel. And how Holmes was in the nightclub the last night Charlie Parker played. And he actually talked to him that night, and how that became the basis for the last two chapters of The Horn. He riffed repeatedly on the importance of writing every day, and to make the reader feel what you do, and that every person's life is interesting. It's all in how you expose it, reveal it, and present it, and to write the beat you hear. And the only character you can and have, must have control over is the narrator. Once you've given life to another, you must allow it to do what it will. You should feel the shape of the story and keep it in view through the months or years of creation. Don't tinker, just flow. Write always, listen always. If you